Welcome back, everyone. My name is Joel Feld, and today's topic, I wanted to discuss iCloud, just iCloud in general. Why you need it, maybe why you don't need it, but mostly if you have an Apple product like an iPhone or an iPad or a Mac, chances are you have it. Let's get started. I was thinking about iCloud, and I've been doing a handful of videos about iCloud and photos, and just overall, I wanted to discuss what iCloud in general, what it is, because it's so much more than just photos. It's a lot of things. I kind of wrote a sentence here. iCloud is Apple's cloud-based ecosystem of applications and tools that you can use on almost any device. Windows computers, Mac computers, iPhone, iPad, probably not an Android though. So we're gonna leave those out of the almost any device. But long story short, iCloud really is a service when it comes down to it. They provide an email account. They provide a place for you to organize your contacts, your calendars, your notes, your reminders. All of this information is all intertwined between all of your Apple products. So chances are, if you have an iPhone, if you have an iPad, if you have an Apple Watch, if you have a Mac, a laptop, an iMac, you have an iCloud account, whether you realize it or not. We also have to remember that iCloud is also an Apple ID, and an Apple ID is also an iCloud account. And Apple, long ago, even when I worked at the Apple store, back then they actually called it Mobile Me, and then they moved it to iCloud. But how they introduced their whole ecosystem is, I'm not gonna lie, a little bit confusing, and some of it kind of is still confusing. So let's look at some of the options of iCloud. I'm gonna go and check the system preferences. And if I go up to the Apple in the top left, go to system preferences, and then this very first choice along the top here, it says my name, Joel Feld. Underneath that, it says Apple ID, iCloud, Media, and App Store. So if I click on Apple ID, this is going to bring me into all of the different options and services that Apple provides. So over on the left here, I have my overview, one account for everything for Apple, which is your Apple ID. It's got my name, phone, email, password, security, payment, shipping, but underneath here is iCloud. And iCloud really is going to be important if you're using services like any of these. So photos, mail, contacts, calendars, reminders, notes, Safari, Keychain, Find My Mac, news, stocks, home, Siri, the list goes on and on and on. And if I pull up my iPad here and go to the same exact spot under settings, notice in the top left, same thing, Joel Feld, Apple ID, iCloud. It's got the same exact categories that we see here on the left on the preferences and the system preferences of the Mac. And if I go to iCloud, again, it's the same exact list. Photos, mail, contacts, calendars, reminders, notes, messages, Safari, news, stocks. It goes on and on. And then it even has other third-party apps like, Procreate, Stop Motion, any apps that intertwine, and it's saving that information in the cloud so that it synchronizes across your devices. Now, most commonly, I would say people use iCloud for one of two things, either as an iCloud backup or for iCloud photos. And then everything else they kind of use, they don't really use, or they use it but don't know that they actually use it. And the biggest thing I see with that is contacts in your calendars. So whenever you're adding an account to your iPhone or your iPad or your Mac computer, whether it's a Gmail account, a Yahoo account, some type of email account that you already have, you're adding these accounts that synchronize different content. So no longer are the days that when you're adding an email account, it's just adding an email account. You're adding much, much more than that. And this here is specifically all dealing with Apple's iCloud account. So when it says mail here, this is not talking about your Gmail account or your Yahoo account or your Hotmail account. This is your email account provided from Apple. It would either end in such and such at iCloud.com, or if you had it before iCloud was iCloud, it would be mobileme.com, which was such and such at me.com, but now it's all iCloud.com. So just know that iCloud in itself is really a service. It's a service that gives you lots of different tools to synchronize across all of your different devices. let's look at it a little bit closer. So on my computer, I'm synchronizing this information. I'm synchronizing the email, the learnwithjoel@icloud.com. So that's the email that I'm using through iCloud, just like you might be using joelfeld@gmail.com or joelfeld@hotmail.com. This is just another email address provided from Apple that's associated with iCloud. If we hop back over here to the web browser, if I go to iCloud.com, I could sign in with learnwithjoel@icloud.com. And this would be the equivalent of you going out to gmail.com, something like that. So if I sign in, it's got the two-factor authentication. Type in the code here, 657249. Yes, I will trust the browser. So here, this is kind of my test account. I'm always working on it, always manipulating something in here, but this is iCloud. It's a service. It's got all of these different apps for me. So contacts, calendar, photos, iCloud Drive, which is like OneDrive for Microsoft or Google Drive for Google environment. It's just a storage facility. I have notes, I have Find Friends, I have Pages, Numbers, and Keynote, which is equivalent to Word, Excel, and PowerPoint, or Google Docs, Google Slides, and Google, Google Docs, Slides, what's the third one? Slides, Google Sheets, that's it. So long story short, it's just a set of tools. It's a service. If I go to Notes, for example, I'm out on the web, I could be on any computer. I could be on a Windows computer, I could go to Notes, I could click up in the top and do, this is a brand new note from iCloud.com. That is now saved in the cloud and it's gonna synchronize to all of my devices. So if I open up Notes here on my computer and open up Notes, and here is that same note to my computer. And if I pull up my iPad, and I find my notes here as well, I can go back to all the folders, go to notes, and here is that note I just typed on iCloud.com. And I can even come to the note here on my iPad and say, this is amazing. So now when I come back, notice it's already updated on my Mac. And if I go out to Safari here, it's already updated there. iCloud is much, much more than just something with photos or dealing with a backup. It's really a collection of tools that synchronize content and information amongst all of your devices. If I go to mail here in the top left, this is my learnwithjoel@icloud.com. And I can come and create a new email message and, you know, have an email service. So I'll cancel out of that. But really, it's just a service. Don't be afraid and it's to use it. It's really a powerful service that's technically free, but you pay for it if you want more storage. And we'll talk about that in a different video. But if we go back to System Preferences, you can see all of the information. It's designed to synchronize from one location to another. And if I were to uncheck any of these boxes, that means that if I make a change on this Mac, for example, it's not gonna update on iCloud.com. It's not gonna update on my iPad or iPhone or any other device. So iCloud, that's iCloud. If I go to, I did a Google search for what is iCloud, and it brought me to the iCloud user guide, which apparently iCloud has a user guide. And they kind of talk about the same things, you know, photos, to keep your photos up to date. Keep all of your files securely stored in iCloud Drive. Keep your contacts, your mail, your calendars all up to date. Collaborate with Pages, Numbers, and Keynote. Your text messages, your Safari bookmarks, your backup and restore. Now backup, that's only for iPhones and iPads. Maybe someday it'll come to the Mac, but they have Time Machine, which works really well with an external hard drive, but so on and so forth, I digress. Locate your friends and devices, which friends is kind of creepy, but devices is really nice because if you lose your phone or you misplaced it, you're able to track it down. The list goes on and on and on as far as what iCloud has to offer you. And I would say it's probably underutilized for the majority of users out there that actually own an iPhone or an iPad or a Mac. And you can really do a lot with it. So I challenge you, I want you to learn and use iCloud a little bit more, and maybe it's time to get rid of that like old AOL email address or Hotmail or Yahoo email, and maybe switch it up and get a new iCloud address. Just saying. So anyways, that's iCloud in a nutshell. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed it. If you have any questions, go ahead, throw some comments down in below. If you liked what you saw, go ahead, hit that subscribe button, tap that little bell, and we'll see you next time.